Hey guys, it's Greg from East Coast Dyes, and today I've got a mid-pocket for the new Warrior Evo 4 with 15mm East Coast mesh. Alright guys, today I've got a really awesome mid-pocket for the Evo 4. It's pretty much the ideal pocket for this head. The Evo 4 is a little wider with a little less aggressive pinch than some of the other NHFS heads on the market, but that makes it ideal for a midfielder, ideal for an attackman that likes a little bit wider of a head, not too narrow. You can string up with a nice tight channel and a really, really great mid-pocket. The head's nice and stiff with the new rail technology they came out with that carves a little bit of the inside sidewall out. It's got a really aggressive look. They added a ton of sidewall holes, so overall I'm a really big fan of the Evo 4, especially with this pocket. So like I said, it's 15mm East Coast mesh. You can see the pocket is right in the middle of the head, really nice definition, and the channel on this for the width of the head is really amazing. It's going to be a perfect ball's width and give you a really smooth release while giving you that accuracy, hold, and consistency that you want from your pocket. So it starts out with a 9-diamond triangle top string. You can just do a regular 9-diamond top string if you would like on the second sidewall hole. So skip the first, do the top string on the second hole. So this sidewall pattern is made up mostly of SIs to keep the pocket from shifting. Since this head is a little wider, the pocket will have a tendency to bag low since the pinch is a little lower. So we did some SIs and a slightly longer bottom string to keep the pocket from shifting and keep it nice and mid. So now I'll show you guys how I strung the sidewall. Alright guys, so now we're going to do up the sidewall on the Warrior Evo 4 with our 15mm East Coast mesh and a mid pocket. So you can see I've already got the 9-diamond top string installed, and that is done on the second sidewall hole. So there's the first one, and we did it down on the second one just to keep it really nice and tight. So to start off our sidewall, here I've got my sidewall black and white so you can see it really well, and we're going to take our sidewall string and put it in through the outside of the third sidewall hole. And then just so that the knot doesn't fall through the hole, I like to just come back around and put the string back through that hole again without having gone through any mesh. So you can see right there, it's just around twice so it won't fall through the hole, and that's in the third sidewall hole. So next, we're going to SI the first 10-diamond row of mesh down to the fourth sidewall hole, also the last large sidewall hole. So just a refresher course for you guys, an SI is where you come down through the top of the mesh, and we want to leave a little loop there just like that, down to the top of the mesh, in through the outside of the sidewall, and then back, see if I can get you a clear view, up through the bottom of the mesh under the loop. And I'll show you a little slower for the next one as well. I'm going to pull that nice and tight. Then we're going to SI the second 10-diamond row of mesh down to the next sidewall hole, having skipped one. So we're going to skip number 5 and go down to number 6. So again, go down through the back of the mesh, in through the outside of the 6th sidewall hole, and then to complete the SI, we're going to take our string, see that little loop we created, come up back through the mesh under that little loop and pull it nice and tight. So then we're going to skip yet another sidewall hole and do yet another SI, pulling it nice and tightly to create that channel and skipping these sidewall holes. So we've got tie on, SI, skip, SI, skip, SI. Then we're going to go another SI with another skip. Alright, so we've got our first 4 diamonds, 1, 2, 3, 4, pulled very tightly with the skips in between. That's going to create this tight area that's going to give us our nice channel. So now we're going to do another SI on the next sidewall hole without skipping any holes. So down to the top in the next sidewall hole and SI it down. That's going to start to loosen up a little bit, but still create that channel that we want. And then we are going to do a 1SI to create our pocket. So for a 1SI, we're going to go up and under the next hole of mesh, and then down through the top, through the back of the one after that. Then we're going to go right into the next sidewall hole, so we're going to be very close to the other one, really scrunch them together to create that pocket, and then SI that second diamond of mesh. So we went up under the first, down to the top of that one, and SI that one. You can see how we bunched it up right there. That's going to create our nice mid pocket. Then we're going to do another SI right in the next hole of mesh and the next sidewall hole. Continue a little bit of that bunching. Then we're going to do another SI on the next sidewall hole. Just like that. So we've got a whole bunch in a row there. So we did our one SI, then an SI, then another SI, all on straight sidewall holes. Then we're going to do a final SI, and we're going to skip a sidewall hole for that one. So you can see that we're going to skip the next sidewall hole just to space that bottom one out a little bit, keep it from bagging out low. After that final SI, you can just take it, the string, go back into the outside of the inside of the sidewall, come right through, and tie that off. So you can see what we end up with is a really, really nice, deep, defined 15 millimeter pocket. Slightly long bottom string since this is such a wide head, but it's going to give us a really, really nice pocket in the end. All right, guys, so I hope you enjoyed that tutorial for the Warrior Evo 4. Let me know if you guys use this pocket, string it up. I'd love to see a video, Instagram picture, tweet me, send me a message on Facebook. Just let me know. I'd love to check it out. If you make a video, send me a message. So anyway, guys, make sure to subscribe for more string videos and tutorials. Like this video if you liked it, and thanks for watching.